Tracking. Today we progress to the next level of tracking. Before we talk about it, I'd like to summarize the step number one we did, the phase number one we did. In the previous video, I explained when we start teaching the dog what we need to do. So just to summarize what we've done in the past, actually a couple of months since we've started tracking with Atos. Very first thing is that you want to make sure it's exciting for the dog. It's a positive experience and the dog is eager to do that. If you see that your dog is not very willing, try changing the bait, or try maybe feeding the dog a little bit less in the evening, so it's a bit more motivated, hungry in the morning when you go tracking. If the dog is distracted, make sure to pull the dog off the track, because you want to make sure that the dog is concentrated, focused on what on the work he's doing. And so the very first step for the dog to learn is that first, it's exciting to do. Second, the dog is learning to use the nose. So at that point, he needs to know that as soon as you hit the track, he needs to start sniffing. And so pretty much that's what we're trying to teach the dog in phase one. And if you remember, we're doing circles, and I've done about 15 sessions of that, where I always do two circles, separate circles, and I've changed the shape of the circles and the size of them. Sometimes they would be smaller, sometimes they would be larger, sometimes they would be slightly elongated. But the point is that I let the dog work through all the problems that the dog has, and he learns very quickly to identify where the circle is. And if he leaves the boundaries with the bait, he quickly comes back. And that's a very important rule, a very important troubleshooting for the dog to learn, because later on when we track on the straight line, the dog needs to follow this certain track, and it's very narrow, and he needs to know once he's off the track, it smells different. So for the phase one, that's pretty much the introduction to troubleshooting for the dog, because you can't help him at this point. He needs to learn on his own. If he is outside of the circle, he needs to come back. And so this is pretty much two main things that we want the dog to learn in phase one. But at the same time, the dog learns to move around in a very chaotic pattern looking for the bait, which is not what we need moving forward. So in phase number two, what we need to teach the dog is that the track is narrow and it goes straight, and you need to follow that pattern forward rather than being chaotic and making different movements around. So today you will see how I teach my dog to start with this. What I've done is that I've laid three tracks. What I do is that basically what we need to teach the dog in this phase, not only just to move forward, but also to look for the each step that the person made on the track, which means that the dog needs to learn to sniff from one step to another, and it will be on the zigzag like this, always moving forward. This phase number two is pretty much teaching him this pattern: first move forward, second move in each step, sniff each single step that was made. And so I've made three tracks. What I've done is that I do the scent pad. So I step in one place, my feet are together, and I step a little bit. I leave randomly a bit of bait, maybe 5-6 pieces of, if you guys remember, I use hot dogs, small pieces of hot dogs. So I left it there, and then I start moving, and I'll show you. I don't make a full step because this is too advanced for the dog yet, not in this phase. In this phase, we want to keep our feet very close, touching like this. So this is how I move. This is how I lay my pattern. So my feet are touching and they're not fully extended. They need to be kind of half steps, right? And so when I move after the scent pad, I make my first step, and then I lift my heel and I place the bait right in my heel. And then I make my second step, I lift my heel, I put the bait in my heel. And this is how I keep doing it. For the beginning, I usually make 5-6 steps like this: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then I make another scent pad. And on the scent pad, I randomly leave the the bait, but it's like a reward, so it's a lot of it. And then I do again. So in my first track, I did three sections like this. I did six steps, send pad, six step, send pad, six step, send pad, and I finished. My second one, I repeated similarly, and I made the third one just in case if something goes wrong. I always have an extra pad, extra track. If the dog is still excited and willing to do, we'll do three. If something goes wrong on the second one or first one, I always have an extra. But my last one, I laid about 15 steps straight, 13, 15 steps straight, and then big reward at the end, and that's the finish for today. And I will continue doing like this for maybe another 10, 15 sessions. So just the dog learns the pattern. It's very important so he remembers to sniff from one step to another. This is what we want the dog to learn. Once I see that he's there, I'll record the next session and I'll explain to you what we're doing next. Happy tracking. That's the first patch of big reward, then a few steps, and then next patch, and then a few more steps, and then the final patch, and I leave the flag flat for me to know that it's indication of the end of the track. That's our very first straight track. You going tracking? Tracking. It's gonna be difficult with the camera, but you have to point to the dog where the bait is and really hold the dog. Make sure that he picks up every bait. Good boy. Good boy. Good. So really hold the dog. Don't let him steer away. Holding him really tight. Okay, he pulled off, so then that's it, he lost it. Once he loses the attention, we pull the dog off. There was some sound there that got him distracted. And he is distracted now, so we're gonna wait a little bit for the next one. Okay, you're going tracking again, pay attention. No, Atos. Pay attention. Good boy. Pay attention. Okay. You need to drop it. Come on now. If the dog is distracted, just walk him a little bit. Good boy. Good boy. Okay. You ready? Are you going tracking again? Going tracking? Good. Good, good boy. That was second one. That was very good. He skips a little bit, but at least he's going on the straight line, which is nice. He's distracted by guys on skateboards. But hey, leave it. Leave it. He's going on a straight line. That's his very, very first straight line. So I'm not very nitpicky about him skipping some of the bait, but that's okay. As long as he goes on the straight line and he's still excited to do that. Later on we'll teach him to go slower, but I think the important part is to hold your dog really tight and very, oops, Atos, and very close to the collar so you can direct him. He's still distracted a little bit, but we're gonna try again. That's the last try. Good boy. I'm gonna hold him. And so that also makes the dog pull, which makes him really willing to work. That's it. Good boy. Good boy. That's his final pad. Good boy. Yay! You did it. Yay! Good boy. When the track is done, I always say, finish. You're done. Finish. Finish. Good boy.